42 pounds. And this is somebody that has been calling me, pestering me, promising to be there for me. Brother Jacob, and my pastor is telling me I shouldn't dance to his tune, that he is a devil in disguise. Ha! He said if I should answer him, that means I'm committing adultery. Because I've not divorced my husband. And I said I wanted to divorce, he's telling me I cannot do that. That the only condition I can divorce is if I caught my husband committing adultery. And since I've not caught him in any adulterous act, I'm not allowed to divorce. But God, Jacob is promising me to be of him. What do I do? So, who's that again? You see? Talk of the devil. Should I pick it? But I get up. No. No, I don't think I should pick this call. Should I pick it? Should I pick it? This is what I get up. No, pastor said I shouldn't. This man is scary. He's showing his love at all times. What do I do? Somebody help me. Somebody help me. What do I do? Somebody help me. Okay, I think I know what to do. I have to give my pastor a call. Yes, I think at this point I just have to call him. This is too much for me. I have to call my pastor. The phone is engaged. I'm sure he'll call me back if he see my missed call. Sometimes when all these pastors are preaching, they don't know what we are going through. What do I do now? Somebody showing love, showing his caring. What do I do? Where's the pastor? Let me call him again. What is he now? Is he still on the phone or what? He's calling me back. Oh, that's my pastor. Thank God he's calling me back. Hello, sir. Yes, sir. Pastor, I'm getting fed up. Yes. You know, it's that time of reception again for the children. They are going back to school. I need to buy a new school shoe, new school bag, new blazer, pencil case, PE kit, dinner money and all stuff, money for bus, bus pass. I just coming back from the bank now. I only have 42 pounds in the account. Yes, sir. You know why I'm even calling you? It's the issue of Brother Jacob. Sir, it's over 10 years now. I can't wait anymore. I think I want to dance to his song. Eh? I shouldn't. That's what you keep saying, but where will I get money from? Where will I get money from? Sir? Church office. I should go to the church office. Okay. To pick up shirt. 300 pound shake. Okay, Pastor. Thank you very much, Pastor. Thank you, sir. Help me to thank the church of the Lord. Thank you for being there at all times, sir. I'm very grateful. Okay. I will surely go there. I will go there. Thank you, Pastor. Okay, sir. Bye. Pastor is so good, he's trying his best. Yes. My church is good, though. You need 300 pound check again. Hey, but come to think of it, what am I even saying? If I keep pick up that check now, what will happen next session again? Will I cry to the church again next session? How long will I be doing this for? No, I'm not going to listen. No, I'm not doing it, Jerry. I think I just have to call Pastor. This brother Jacob. Yes, I must call Jacob. It's time for me to dance to his tune. Because how am I going to do it? Yes. Yes, I just have to call him. No. I have to call him. This pastor doesn't understand at all.
Sister me. You are still on heat. Checking if you want to call brother Jacob.
I thought you were sleeping. When are you?
I've been there. All true.
So you've heard all of this? I've
been hearing everything you were saying. I've heard everything. And I can't even believe that after that short miracle, you're still contemplating on calling Brother Jacob. Mm-hmm. Auntie me, you, our role model, where is your faith? You that every woman in the church, even in this community, they look up to you. Yeah? Your husband has gone for how many years now? 10 years, Auntie Me. 10 years.
Auntie Me. You don't understand.
I understand you.
You don't understand.
Auntie Me, I understand you. And that is why I'm so proud of you. And that is what is keeping me, Auntie Me. That is what is keeping so many women around us. Because of your attribute. Because of your faith. Because of all those things you portray. But look at you in the house. If somebody show the world what you're doing in the house, what would they do?
Yeah, but what do you want me to do?
Auntie,
when Jacob is saying he's going to be there for me, I can't see for over 10 years.
You are just believing in things you see. Faith is believing in things you do not see. Auntie, you know all these things. You all know all these things. You are the one teaching us. You are the one bringing us up. The Bible says in Philippians 4, it says, be anxious for nothing. The Bible says, be anxious for nothing. Auntie, you're anxious. You are thinking of, because of God has blessed you with so much goodness. You have two daughters. One is in the university. And you are now thinking, are you the one that have been doing all this? All this while that their daddy has gone. Even me and Timmy, living under your roof, who has been supplying all those needs. He said he will supply our needs according to his mercy in his glory, Christ Jesus. So who has been supplying? Is it by your might, auntie? It is by your power. Is it by your wisdom? It's not getting too much. I don't know why you're anxious. Instead of you in thanksgiving, to begin to request, to place your petition to God. The Bible tells us again, he said he will supply all our needs. All our needs. And he's been doing it. He just did one for you. And you are here counting all the problems. Brother Jacob. Do you think Brother Jacob is better than Sharon's dad? Do you think he's better than him? How do you know that if you now give in to Brother Jacob and Timmy, it will be better? How do you know that if you give in to him today, it won't even be worse? It won't change to you. Yes, you say, Pastor, I've said it. There is a devil in disguise. How do you, what did you have to wear his ass, to search his ass?
I don't think those pastors know what we are going through.
And Timmy, see, God just supplied your need. Pastor just called you to come and pick up the chair.
Yes.
And you're still going back to calling Brother Jacob. Auntie, I don't know, where is your dignity? Where is your dignity, Auntie? Where is your dignity? Where is your passion for God? Where is your spirit? Where is that spirit that I can do all things through Christ who strengthens me? Where is your strength? So if you are doing this, what do you want to preach to those other women that are single mothers? That even have husbands, some women, they have husbands in their house living together. They can't even enjoy, Auntie. See, they can't enjoy the grace of God that you are enjoying. Look at you. Who can say that you don't even, your husband is not living here? For the past 10 years, look at your skin. Look at those children. You are doing well. Is it by your grace, Auntie? Is it by your wisdom? Instead of you to be thankful to God, you are here complaining. You are here complaining. I'm going back to Brother Jacob. Auntie, if it is this Brother Jacob you want to stand by, crying on it. I don't know what to say again. But I think you should be thankful to God and begin to put your request to God in thanksgiving. Me, I'm making a cup of tea, Auntie. Do you want a cup of tea? No. Pale, Auntie Mio.
Lord. Are you listening? Are you still there, Lord? Are you still there, Lord? I believe you can turn things around. Yes. Let me see my letters. Are you letters? You see? Talk, another day. SS water. Hey, another bill. Bill upon bill. 42 pounds in the account. Which one is this again? There's revenue and customs. What did they say again? They did not find me. There's revenue. Pass the phone. £4,000. Damola! Damola!
Auntie, what again? What again? Why are you calling me?
Why, Damola?
Am I into this business of Brad Jacob's story again or what?
Am I seeing right?
What?
Look.
What? Wow.
That's
for. Oh my God.
4,000.
Our God is good. Auntie, did you just say it? Well, I'm just telling you. See, our God said he will make a way where there is no way. He will make rivers in the desert. This is evidence of it.
That's what I was
saying. This is evidence of it. We should be thankful. Follow along with thinking. You are so faithful
for this year.
You see, he made a way. That is what we have to start praying for. This is seriously. You are not the one that's
not feeling.
Father,
forgive us. Thank you for
this. We thank you.
Thank God for this.
$4,000.
£3,000.
Auntie, that's
the attitude. To
hell with you,
Brother Jacob.
Okay, now to hell with
Brother Jacob. He has done it.
Yes, Auntie. I'm still drinking my tea.
Please make me tea. You want
Thank you, Jesus.
What is it that is bothering you? What is the problem that you think you have that the Lord cannot solve? Let me tell you something. The devil is rolling around looking for whom to devour. He will come to you in the form of an helper. I can assure you that he will drag you until he sees you in the pit. The Lord says, come unto me, all ye that live and heavy laden, and I will give you rest. Irrespective of whatever you are going through, always look up unto God, because your help is not with any other person but God. He created you. He knows what you are going through, and He's the only one that knows the solution to your problem. Cast your burden upon the Lord, for He shall resolve your issue. Bless you.